This video is an overview of the ITOM Event Management and Operational Intelligence applications. In the ServiceNow system, an event is a notification from a CI in your IT system or the cloud about an issue your IT team should be aware of, like a failure or a warning. The event contains a variety of information about the issue to help diagnose and resolve it. A metric is a measure of an operating characteristic for a device over a certain time period, like a server's CPU or memory usage. The ITOM Event Management and Operational Intelligence applications collect and analyze events and operational metrics to help your IT team monitor the health of your system, anticipate and prevent outages, and resolve issues quickly with minimal impact to your operations. Let's take a look at the event management process. At the start, event management collects events from monitors on your system, like SCOM and SolarWinds. Event management stores the events in the event table. Next, event management creates an alert to let your IT team know about the issue. To do this, event management applies event rules. These rules can do several things, like mapping fields in the event to fields in the alert, associating or binding events to specific CIs, applying thresholds for the number and rate of recurring events, and filtering out certain events. Next, event management groups related alerts and identifies a primary alert. Event management uses machine learning to do this automatically. You can define alert correlation rules yourself to do this grouping, and you can group alerts manually. Machine learning incorporates manual groupings into its algorithms. Finally, event management uses alert rules to perform actions to remedy the issue, typically by creating an incident, launching a remediation workflow, or recommending a knowledge article. Event management also calculates the cumulative impact of the issue on CIs and business services. As you look at alerts, keep in mind, when a CI is in maintenance, alerts for that CI aren't included in alert displays or impact calculations. Next, let's look at a few different ways to monitor alerts. One way is the Event Management Dashboard. Each tile in the main display represents a business service or an alert group. The size of the tile represents the priority of the service or group. By severity, business criticality, or cost. You can also define your own priority criteria. The color of the tile represents the highest level alert for any CI in the service or group. Just click a tile to see the alerts for the service or group in the list down below. Or double-click the tile to see the business service itself. Here you'll see a topology map of the CIs in the service and their relationships, the active alerts for the service, the impact history, and a tree showing the impact of the alerts throughout the service. You can click any CI in the map or the tree to see the alerts for that CI, and you can click any alert to see the CIs impacted by that alert. The Alert Console lists individual alerts. You can open any alert to see the details, including the events associated with the alert. And finally, the overview gives you a quick summary of active alerts and affected business services. Now let's take a look at the operational intelligence process. At the start, OI connectors on ServiceNow mid-servers on your network collect performance metrics from monitors on your system, like SCOM and SolarWinds. Like event management, OI uses event rules to bind individual metrics to specific CIs. OI components on the mid-servers normalize the metric data based on the event rules and send it to the instance. OI uses the metric data to create statistical models of each metric, reflecting the normal range of values for the metric. OI on the mid-servers continually evaluates metrics from the sources against the models to identify values outside the normal range, or anomalies. OI assigns an anomaly score to indicate the severity of each anomaly. For anomalies that exceed a threshold, OI generates an anomaly event and sends it to the instance. On the instance, OI uses event rules to create anomaly alerts based on the anomaly events, similar to event management as we saw earlier. OI can promote anomaly alerts to IT alerts. From here on, the OI process is the same as event management. OI uses alert rules to create an incident, launch a remediation workflow, or recommend a knowledge article. Finally, let's look at some ways to view metric data and alerts. The Operational Intelligence Anomaly Map gives you an overview of anomalies for individual CIs. In the list on the left, you can view the 10 current most anomalous CIs, a list of any CIs you choose, the CIs for a specific business service, or the CIs in a specific CMDB group. The chart shows the anomaly history for each CI in the list from earlier time ranges up to the present. The color of each tile indicates the highest anomaly score for all the metrics for that CI at that time. Point to a tile to see the details for that CI and time range, and click a tile to open the Metrics Explorer for the CI. The Metrics Explorer shows the metrics for an individual CI. The list on the right gives you the same views as the screen we just saw: the 10 most anomalous CIs, a list of CIs you choose, the CIs in a business service, or the CIs in a CMDB group. Click a CI to see the metrics for that CI. The chart shows individual metrics over time. To add a metric to the chart, just drag and drop it from the list. To see the value at any point in time, just point to that time. You can choose a different time slice here, or select a time slice on the chart. You can change the settings to see the anomaly scores. You can even correlate multiple metrics. Remember the event management topology map we saw earlier? When you have event management and OI together, the metrics pane lists the CIs for the service or group. Click a CI to see metrics for that CI, and click View Metrics to open the Metrics Explorer for that CI. Another useful view is the Anomaly Alerts list. This is a list of alerts generated from anomalies that OI detected in the CIs in your system. Click any alert for more details, and right-click any alert and choose View Metrics to open the Metrics Explorer for the CI for that alert. In our next video, we'll look at collecting events and metrics. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.